It's time for the Family Feud, introducing the Rallis family. Dean, Jan, Wade, Aaron, and Neil, ready for action. And the McCawley family. Don, Carol, Tim, Randy, and Jennifer. On your marks, let's start the Family Feud. With the star of Family Feud, Richard Dawson.
There's $10,000 to give away, and the Rallis with lighted money. Right here.
Yeah.
All right, Dean.
Nice.
Who you got here?
Well, I'm fortunate to have here to my left my wife, Jan.
Hello, Jan.
How do you do, Richard?
My brother-in-law, Wade.
Good to see you, Wade.
His wife, my sister-in-law, Erin.
Hi.
Hi, darling.
And after incurring two weddings in 3 years,
yeah,
my financially bankrupt father-in-law fathered these two lovely women, Neil.
I like your style.
Thank you.
How'd you meet that pretty lady?
I met her in a crosswalk at the University of Southern California.
Yes, you did.
I did, 2 years ago.
Were you in a car?
No, I was on a bike.
You were on a bike.
That's almost better. Ran into each other.
No, but that's better because then you can talk.
That's
in a
right.
Car. What did you say to her when you saw her?
I said hi.
Not original, but it seemed to have worked because she's here with you.
I got her.
Yeah. When he said hi, what did you just like the look of him? Is that why you spoke to him?
No, actually, before he said hello, I said, I understand you go to law school. I'd like to get together sometime and talk about it.
I like that.
Very smart.
Richard, we have a...
That's neat. I love that.
We have something for you. Neil, down at the end there, would like to...
Neil,
Neil down there. Yes, he'd like to give you something.
I don't like to. Yeah, well, I shouldn't really, I guess. I told me to kneel down at the end.
You may rise,
well,
Richard.
Thank you, Neil. How are you, Jim?
Well, thank you.
What do you got here?
Well, I work for a large corporation, and
yeah,
we have some land down in Florida.
Oh, I'll buy some. Is it swamp land? I love it.
We have some land in Anaheim.
Uh-huh.
And we have some land in Burbank. And at Burbank, we've been publicizing and promoting one movie star for over 50 years. His picture's on this necktie that I'd like to give to you.
It's got to be Uncle John, hasn't it?
No.
Is it?
No.
Oh, it's Mick.
Mickey.
Look.
Hi.
Yeah, that's lovely. Thank you. Paulie's here. Let's make him feel nice. Don, you're looking pretty good.
How are you?
Who you got here, champ?
This is my lovely wife, Carol.
Hello. Hi, Richard.
And this is the brain of the family, my son-in-law, Tim.
Hi, Richard.
Welcome, Tim.
And next to him is my sexy daughter, Randy. That's
Randy.
Tim's wife. You know,
hi, Richard.
Yes.
Hi,
and that smashing redhead on the end, she's a newlywed.
You've
got to give her a little special treatment
what's
tonight.
Name?
And that's Jennifer.
Jennifer, mm-hmm. Welcome.
Hi.
It's right again. You've got a nice family. Let's see, little wings here. You're a flyer,
Yes, I am, Richard.
Have your own plane? I mean, a private plane?
Yeah, I have my own plane.
Yeah?
We have a flying business.
What do you have?
I'm an Apache, Piper Apache.
Yeah. You
know, an old Apache.
Yeah, yeah, I know. Uh-huh. Do you fly, Carol?
Yes, I have a license.
Pretty snazzy, yeah. Anybody else in the family fly?
Student pilot.
Student for Tim?
Yeah.
Well, he's a brain, so he'll pick it up quickly.
Yeah, he'll pick it up quick.
How long have you been flying?
40 years.
Yeah. Now, what's the name of your company? So you got a flying company?
Well, actually, Richard, I'm a professor of anatomy and physiology at San Bernardino Valley College.
Are you really?
And some of my students.
I think they're applauding anatomy, I'll tell you the truth.
Yeah, my favorite class is anatomy by the Braille method. I teach it in night.
Ah, yes. I'm studying it myself.
And the other hat I wear is vice president of Archold Aviation. You know, and wearing two hats is pretty difficult sometimes.
Maybe I could help you
and
out.
Therefore, I would hope you would help me out, Richard,
Ooh,
and wear
this is a pretty that, snazzy hat
that
there.
Archold Aviation hat.
There you go. I wear it with pride. I thank you. How long would it take me to learn to fly? Truly, average person, how long?
The average person to get their private license so that they can fly any place in the world carrying passengers is 40 hours.
40 hours.
20 hours solo, 20 hours dual instruction.
Let me take you up and come on down.
Well, you come down and see us.
Come on, let's play the thing.
Yeah.
100 people surveyed, top five answers on the board. You got to try and find the most popular answer. Here's the question. Name something you really miss when it has to be repaired. Yes, sir.
A car.
Car. Number one, one answer will be it.
My eyeglasses.
Your spectacles. Not that.
Play
or pass.
Play. We'll play, Richard.
You were right. They're going to play. Get to meet this pretty lady. How you doing? Did you become a lawyer?
No, I was on my way, and he deterred me. Now I play golf for a living.
Yeah?
He practices his law, and I practice my golf.
You're a professional golfer?
Almost. I'm going to beat him one of these days.
Yeah? Well, congratulations. What do you really miss when it has to be repaired?
Richard, I'd say your television set.
Yeah, that's a good idea. Good day. Good to be a lawyer. How are you? Good to see you, champ. What would you say?
Well, I would have to say the stereo.
Stereo?
Yeah.
Stereo! Yeah! Hi. How you doing?
Hi, fine.
What would you say, madame?
I would say your washer.
Washer? No, not there. First try. Neil.
A wristwatch.
Good answer.
Wristwatch! Yeah. One answer lefty. Something you really miss when it has to be repaired.
Richard, what about a telephone?
Telephone. If it's there, sure, you got it all. If not, second strike. Telephone? No.
Yeah. Really miss when he has to. Not when he has to be repaired, right? I'll say your dryer.
A dryer. No. $92 up there. Dom?
Vacuum.
We're going to say vacuum, Richard.
Vacuum. All right, sir. If that's there, you get the $92. If not, Dean does. Vacuum? You got it. Five? It reminds me, I've got to pick mine up. It's down on Pico being fixed. 92? Nothing? Let's go.
Thank you.
100 people surveyed, top seven answers on the board. Here's the question. There are lots of things it would be hard to do if you did not have a thumb. Name one. Yeah.
I'll say right.
Right.
We're going to play, Richard.
Okay. This is a bizarre question. This is really a weird question. And I don't like to think of,
I would have to say, put a thumbtack in.
Push a thumbtack in. No. Wait, that was a great answer. Boy, oh, boy. Lord forbid, you don't have a thumb. What would be hard to do, Don?
All I can think of is wear gloves.
Yeah, because that thing would keep flapping.
Good answer, here.
Wear gloves. No. Oh.
Dress or tie your shoes.
Uh-huh. Okay. Tie your shoes. What's hard to do if you don't have a thumb?
I would say throw a ball or throw an object.
Okay. Throw a ball. Would be, I think, wouldn't it?
Yeah, I think so.
I really do. I think a chance for you to get $48.
Second thumb.
Your answer.
I'm going to say, Richard, button the button.
Button a button?
Button a button.
Button a button. You got it. Two. Three. Well, then you wouldn't have a problem very long, would you? Five. Seven. I still think this is probably the most disgusting answer. We'll be back right after. Okay? 248, let's go. First family to get to 300, get two thumbs and a chance to play for $10,000. 100 people surveyed, top six answers on the board. Here's the question. Name a musical instrument. Yeah.
A guitar.
Guitar? Remove his thumb. I'm sorry, we have to be strict. Here's the full question. Name a musical instrument that most children learn to play. Yes.
The drums. Drums.
Drums!
We're gonna play, Richard.
Oh, they're gonna play.
Yeah, they're gonna play.
Good. All right. Musical instrument that most children learn to play.
A piano.
Yeah. Good answer.
Piano.
A harmonica.
Harmonica. Yeah. Harmonica played. Not there. It was a good answer, Chad. See?
Richard, I say an organ.
Organ. Organ? No. Or the heart or the liver or something like that.
I'm going to have to say they go to their violin lessons.
Yeah.
Yeah. Good answer.
Come on. Violin. Yeah. Yes, sir.
Well, I'm going to have to say the flute.
Okay. Good.
Play. Is there all right if not first strike? Flute! You got it. Right. One more, pretty.
A trumpet.
Trumpet! Yeah. A trumpet! Yeah. 186 plays 48. Let's go. How you doing?
Fine.
Nice to see you.
Thank you.
Don't be nervous. Come on now. We're going to have a good time. Okay. All right? Sure we are. Here we go. Dollar values are doubled. 100 people surveyed. Top five answers on the board. Here's the question. Name a country known for cheese. Yeah.
Holland.
Holland.
Good.
Two answers will beat it. A country known for cheese.
Switzerland.
Very good. Yeah. Switzerland. Then you should obviously be more nervous all the time. It's the number one answer. Our newlywed. How you doing?
Great, thanks.
Country known for cheese.
Germany.
Germany. Nine.
Nine.
Nicht gut.
Das ist der Parmesan cheese in Italy.
Very good.
Very good, right.
Hey, Italia. Italia. Well done. Can it count? Country known for cheese.
Denmark.
Something rotten in Denmark?
Well, the only other kind of cheese I know of is American cheese.
Why not? There, you got it. America. No. Country known for cheese. Come on, give me any country.
France.
Yeah.
Good.
France is there. You got it. If not, third strike. Vive la France.
Vive la France.
238, 186. Let's go. Jennifer Neal. Dollar values are tripled. This is going to decide it. 100 people surveyed. Top four answers on the board. Here's the question. Name a chore a husband usually does.
Yeah. Puts out the garbage.
Garbage? Yeah. What are we going to do?
We're going to play.
We're going to play, darling.
Okay.
Fifth question. I'll read it once. I will not repeat it. You have 3 seconds to answer it when I get there. Nothing to it. Name a chore a husband usually does.
Mow the lawn.
Mow the lawn.
Feed the dog.
Feed the dog. Not that. Wait, 3 seconds.
I would say do the laundry.
Okay, do the laundry.
Come on, Aaron.
Clean up after the animals.
Uh-huh. Is that okay if not, third try? Clean up after the animals. No. I'd like to be the champs. There are two unrevealed answers. Give me one of them.
Wash the car.
I'm going to say, Richard.
Give it to me, whatever it is.
Wash the car.
Yeah.
If it's there, sir, you play for $10,000. If not, Dean, you will. Wash the car. Number three. Do the dishes. And we laughed when you said laundry, right?
Yes.
I mean, they should do it all, but... Got $186 there. We're rounded off to $200. We have nice prizes for you. I'm sorry you didn't win more. You're a nice family. Thank you for being here.
Thank you.
I always have to say goodbye to somebody. I'm sorry. It has to be you. Thank you. Watch the show. You'll see I'll wear Mickey. Thank you. Full play. Who's first? Carol and Tim, they want $10,000, and they'll try right after this. You know we love you. We want you to win the money. Good
Thank
luck.
Thank you.
15 seconds for Carol, please. Tell me how long a couple should be married before starting a family.
2 years.
Something you put a padlock on.
Your garage.
Something children love to play in.
The mud.
Something people put in pancakes.
Blueberries.
A geometric shape.
A square.
Very good. How long should a couple be married before starting a family? You said 2 years. Survey said. What do you put a padlock on? Garage. Survey. 14. Children love to play in the mud, you said. Survey said. 20. People put in pancakes. Nobody. Survey. Geometric shape. Thank you, boys. A square. And to service head. Right next to public. Welcome to Tim. Woo-hoo. Come on, Tim. You just need 39 points. You got $10,000. Please remind everyone the answers Carol gave us. 20 seconds on the clock, please. Good luck.
Thank you.
I mean, how long a couple should be married before starting a family?
4 years.
Something you put a padlock on.
Gate.
Something children love to play in.
Sandbox.
Something people put in pancakes.
In? Blueberries.
Try again.
Bananas.
A geometric shape.
Round.
Good. How long couples should be married before starting a family? 2 years. Number one answer. You said 4. Survey said 2. Something to put a padlock on. Bicycle number one. You said gate. Survey said 8. Something children love to play in. You said a sandbox. You need 29 points for $10,000. Survey said. Sand was the number one answer. Something put in pancakes. Blueberries, number one. You said banana. If it's worth 1 point, you have the money. Survey said. Geometric shape. Square was number one. You said round. 1 point we need. Oh, no. Survey said. Sir, the world would be a better place without you and your kind. Prepare to meet thy doom. Signed, a loyal fan. What's your name, darling? Christy, you're so cute.
Oh,
thank you.
Callies, $10,481.